Are you using Zoom to record your podcast or maybe even your podcast interviews, but you're not quite sure how to get it from Zoom to your audio software? That is exactly what this video is about today. I'm going to show you how to take a Zoom file and upload it into Audacity. So let's get right to it. Hey y'all, Crystal here today, and I'm excited to help you turn those Zoom files into your podcast. Oh my gosh, I'm really excited about this because I used Zoom for a really long time whenever I was just getting started with my podcast. And I think it's so important to understand that there are some nuances that go into taking a Zoom file, right, which is video, and using it in Audacity, which is an audio platform. You can actually watch this video right here. It's a little outdated on how Zoom works, and there's been a lot of updates since this first video came out, but it shows you like all the mechanics behind setting up a Zoom interview and how to take it from this is what I need to do to get started to this is a finished product. But particularly in this video today, I'm just gonna show you how to take a Zoom file that's already done and actually import it into Audacity. So let's go over to the computer and let me show you how it's done. Okay, so here we are in my Zoom account. And this is actually a call I did recently and I thought, why don't we use this as a great demonstration? So let's pretend you've already recorded your podcast interview with your guest, or maybe you're using Zoom to record your podcast because you wanna use the video for it as well. I think this is a great option. Actually, if you wanna learn more about video podcasts, make sure you check out this right here because it has some tools and strategies that you can use. But yeah, this is really important to know that now Zoom has the ability for you to download the audio only. Okay, I spoke too soon because I'm gonna show you what happens whenever I take this audio file and I try to drag it directly into Audacity. So this is what happens. If I were to just take this and drag it all the way to Audacity and try to drop it in, I get this error. And it's telling me that it is not in a file that is compatible to be used in Audacity. So I had to interrupt real fast and ask you, are you using Zoom just to record podcast interviews? Are you using it for coaching calls? Are you using it to talk one-on-one with your clients? Are you using it for team spaces? I wanna know because there are a lot of different softwares out there and I'm wondering how many podcasters here are using Zoom on a regular basis so I can support you better in using Zoom to create awesome podcast content. So tell me in the comments below. Okay, let's get back to the video. So what I need to do is actually go to a website that I like to use. It's called CloudConvert.com. And I'm gonna show you how you can convert this to an audio file that you can use on your podcast. Okay, so I'm gonna click okay. We're gonna go back over here and then Cloud Convert. This is exactly what I have. I have a semi-paid version where I paid for some credits up front, but you can absolutely do this as a free version if you only need to do so many from time to time. I know there's a lot of other file converter sites out there. This is the one that I just happen to use very often. So I'll upload it here. Okay, now it is uploaded and now we just simply have to convert it and we have to select what we want to convert it to. So I'm going to choose to convert it. You can either do an MP3 or a WAV file. I like to use WAV files. So I will click WAV and then just simply click the convert button. It'll take it a second, it uploads it, it converts it. And while it's doing this, I think it's important to note that you can absolutely take out some of these processes by doing it like in bulk. So if you are doing a lot of podcast episodes at one time, a lot of interviews, I would wait and kind of save this to do it all at once. That way you're not having to go back and convert a lot of your Zoom files like back and forth, back and forth. Okay, so it's ready. I'm gonna click download. Now we are going to take this WAV file whenever it's done downloading, and I'm going to drag that into Audacity and be able to use the audio file there. Because if you're not familiar with Audacity, it has to be an MP3 or a WAV file in order to import it into Audacity. Okay, so it's telling me it's ready to go. So I'm going to take this file. Again, we're going to try to drag it over here. And now it is importing this WAV file. I'm going to show you in a second another way that you can do this once this is finished processing, because I think it's important to know that you can drag and drop it. But there's also an option to go to File and Import to get it in there as well. Okay, so there it is. Now we have an audio file that we can edit if there's parts that we need to cut out, if we need to adjust the volume, whatever we need to do. But the other way that I would go about getting this file in here, if you don't want to use the drag and drop feature, is go to File and Import. This is where the other option is. You would go to audio and then you would simply go find the file that you want to import into Audacity, and that is how you take a Zoom file and get it into Audacity in order to edit it for your podcast. So I hope that you found today's tutorial helpful. Let me know in the comments if you have any other questions about how to take your Zoom files and use them in Audacity. Tell me in the comments below what software you are using. Are you using Audacity strictly? Are you trying out several different softwares? Because I have a video right here that is all about my favorite platforms to record your podcast. Zoom is one of them, and I have a few other recommendations if you are looking to try something new. So make sure you check out that video, but that's all I have for you in this video today. Make sure you check out these other videos right here, all about podcasting and growing and running your online business. We have a ton there to help you create a better format, to record your solo episodes, and to figure out how podcasting can best work for you. And as always, remember, keep it up. We all have to start somewhere.